flat out fantastic that there are more people these days who've heard of and understand what usability and the field of user experience are. I even hear my family and non-UX friends saying stuff like, my banking app isn't very user-friendly, or this site has terrible usability. It's just not intuitive. Isn't it so nice to be appreciated? Sure, but usability isn't some abstract concept, even though people can inherently just kind of feel when it's poor. Usability is actually defined by 5 different quality components. Learnability is concerned with how easy it is for users to accomplish basic tasks the first time they use the system. So can they get started within a reasonable amount of time, or is there a steep learning curve? Efficiency asks, how quickly can users perform important tasks after that initial learning period? Memorability refers to how easily users can reestablish proficiencies if they come back to a design after a period of not using it. Errors, of course, refers to how many errors users make, how severe those errors are, and how easily they can recover from them. And then finally, satisfaction refers to just how pleasant a thing is to use. If we remove any one of those components from the puzzle, usability suffers. For example, if we don't consider how easily users can learn the system, and we rely on the false assumption that they're just gonna read the manual, they're not gonna be motivated to keep using the design, and they'll start looking for something better. Even in situations where users don't have a choice but to keep using the system, like maybe a specialized application in a workplace environment, systems with low learnability are still going to hinder productivity. Now, in another example, let's say users can quickly learn basic tasks through patterns like wizards or step-by-step workflows, but the system isn't flexible. There's no accelerators, there are no shortcuts to speed up the processes over time or increase performance for users. Here, usability suffers because the system is inefficient. Frequent users or expert users are going to quickly become frustrated with this type of design. And one more time, let's consider a system with low satisfaction. Even if a system enables users to efficiently complete tasks, if it's an unpleasant experience, then users are going to prefer to do those tasks elsewhere. This is an especially risky scenario for generalized tasks, things like information seeking or productivity tasks or shopping, because there are no shortages of websites and applications for users to choose from to do those sorts of things. The easiest way to understand how your design performs across all of these components is with simple, qualitative usability testing. Watch representative users use the design and observe where they have any difficulties. An ideal system tracks high in all 5 of these components. However, in the real world, design trade-offs often have to be made. Iterative testing and design will help you identify the biggest challenges and improve overall usability over time.